Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Let's play the spam. Greetings and salutations, fellow gamers. My name is Jonathan Paula, back here on Game Time with a brand new sub-series we're going to call Let's Play the Spam. Sort of a spin on my other show on the Jogwheel channel, Don't Eat the Spam. On this show, we're going to feature some mobile games, freeware apps, indie titles, and just trial runs of sort of Flash-based video games in short one-off episodes. One game, one episode, 10 to 20 minutes. It might be edited down from a longer gameplay session, or you'll just see my entire first 20 minutes in real time, uninterrupted. And the reason I'm doing this is because somewhere, at some point, somebody put me on one of those mailing lists. And now, once a day, every day, somebody sends out a mass mailer, play my game, feature this, talk about this, here's a Steam code, will you feature? So I thought, what better way to clean out my inbox than to actually play these games? And some of them could be really good, and others could be stuff I will never play in my worst nightmare, but that's why this is going to be entertaining. We never know what we're going to get. It's just sort of a spin of the wheel, going to pluck it out and find what happens. And I don't have to go far to find our first game, which was sent to me just earlier today. It's called High Noon Revolver, a 2D action shooter, which releases this week, January 25th, 2017. In partnership with Mike Studios developer Dungeon Souls, we're releasing High Noon Revolver, a 2D action shooter in which you blast your way across three levels of platforming, collecting gold and obtaining upgrades. We are pleased to announce that High Noon Revolver will be released on Steam and Humble Store on Wednesday, January 25th, 2017. So, with that preamble out of the way, let's head over to my desktop. We have Skype open, not Skype, Steam. And I already set up the controls, the game works, recording works, we are set to go. Mike Studios, it's called High Noon Revolver, and the music, very Ennio Morricone, circa the Man With No Name trilogy. Let's jump right into it. Choose your gunslinger. Wesley, chicken, okay, so we got those unlockables. Revives after death, but decreases max HP. Fires a fast exploding... I like Wesley. Let's go with, like, the standard guy. He's like your Mario. And we can pick our color. Let's go with orange, because that looks dope, and I can probably see him better on the screen. Wanted. Dead or alive. Golden scar. 500,000? Jesus, this game just kind of jumps you right into the big bucks. Big money bucks. Alright, is this an auto-scroller? Oh, yeah, I'm kind of forced along here. Oh, jeez. Oh, Jesus. All right, so we got giant scorpions on the top row. I can hop between them. That's exciting. This reminds me a bit of... And this is a favorable comparison, for sure, of the original Mario Bros. Minigame, where you and Luigi would square off on a sort of symmetrical screen. Nice! I have to say, first immediate impressions... So these aren't even really first impressions. We've been at it for, what, 12 seconds now. This is, it's fun, it's whatever, it's not, it's what I expected, it's a 2D shooter, not a lot to it, anybody can design one of these. If that's not me, of course, I can't design them. Ooh, what's this? Oh, nice! My point was, first impressions, gameplay, traditional, but the music is excellent. Good sound effects, good music, I'm digging that so far. And it's simple, right? You just smash the controller and walk in one direction here. Yes, yes, die. Oh, I got some gold. I got 15 gold so far. Oh, you can't see that. My head's in the way. I'll have to... Can I pause? Dun-dun, dun-dun-dun. Where can I move my head to? Oop, I came out of the box. That's embarrassing. Let's do that. Yes! Now that's a little better. Now you can see. Now you can see the monies I earned. So what are all the heads-up display... Oh, shoot, that was close. I got a... What? Oh, no.
Oh, no, I died!
Ooh, a new high score, though. That's... quick restart. I can't. There's stuff in every corner of the game. Nobody ever designs with face cams in mind. It's one of the reasons I don't usually use them. But I thought for this series, it's gonna be a little different. Every game is unique. Every game is completely new. I'm playing everything completely blind. That's sort of the point. I mean, this game is brand new, like nobody's played it yet. It doesn't even come out yet. I'm getting first dibs, yo, because I'm a famous YouTuber. I got all the likes, I got all the engagements.
What are you talking about? Nobody watches his shit channel no more, John.
Yes, 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 yes. All right, so if I die again with Wesley, I think we gotta switch to Chicken Man. Big old chicken tendy's gonna come up here and shoot up to Old Wild West. Wild Wild West. You don't wanna see my hand where my hip be at. Will Smith, getting us through the 19th century in grand style. These guys look like Koopa shells here, the spiky dudes. I don't like that they can shoot diagonally, whereas I can't, and I feel like it's a disadvantage for old Wesley here. Oh shit. Oh yeah, now I got the skills, boy. I got the moves like Jagger. If Mick Jagger was an old West gunslinger, and let's be honest, he's old enough to have existed in that century. As for how he fares behind a gun, I'm guessing not well. He made his living singing songs, not shooting the bad guys. Oh, Jesus Christmas. What the? Jiminy. No. No. Jesus Christ, this game is intense. You want the... I didn't even notice that. My projectiles actually don't... They have a range limit. I didn't even see that at first. Well, I kind of walked into that one, didn't you? That's what he said. Why would he say that? That doesn't make any sense, John. There's nothing sexual about that. All right, this... Whoa, what just happened? I just got a jumper badge. What does that mean? What did I do for that? Yes, I have 12. What is 22? What does this get me? What is 22 coins worth? Do I get a cash mint and buy myself like a tote bag or something? Come. Hold on a second. Jump. Shit, I can roll? Skill back. Skill back. Escape. Whoa, this changes everything. Music, again, highlighted this experience for me so far. High Noon Revolver. Nothing else about it is supremely unique, but it's enjoyable, and it is certainly challenging. I don't know if it's a good thing that I can't even get past the first level, but I assume that if you're paying whatever it is, like the $9.99 to play some indie title on Steam, you're going out of your way to find a gaming experience. So you're no stranger to... I need some more health. I need to concentrate. You're no stranger to challenges. Like, if you're on Steam looking for a game like this, something tells me you don't want, like, the easy, breezy, beautiful cover girl. You want something that's going to give you a money for your run. Ooh, I unlocked a character. The Sniper. Let's go to the main menu and try out The Sniper. Now that we've unlocked him. Throws a flaming bomb to a target enemy. Ooh, I like this. So her extra ability. All right, this is proving okay so far. I'm in it. I'm on it, guys. All right, full health, and we're past the first stage. 8 coins under our belt in our little girl purse, our little girl wallet. What do you call those? Girl wallets. Bam, bam, bam. Explosive. I can shoot backwards without even looking. Oh geez, oh geez. Yes, health. All right, now I got three H. Oh, son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. Whoa, everything's moving around. Every time I shoot, my Annie character goes flying off the screen in another direction here. All right. Let's lock and load. Health, health, health. Jesus. No. I'm gonna... Edgar needs his skin suit. Okay. If you think you can do a better job at High Noon, go buy the fucking game yourself and shut up already. don't know, the developers would probably love it. Because, you know, this is an indie title and they need all the help they can get. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying it sarcastically, but I mean it earnestly. That's confusing. This is the three levels really adds a dimension, a dimensional aspect to this game that I was not prepared for. This is it. This is the life that we're, that all the cheese in China comes back and we're gonna win. Okay, not if I keep dying. Not if I keep dying. I died. I'm a freaking failure. Okay, we've unlocked a new character. Zero fires a slow-moving projectile that explode when hit by Zero's laser. Alright, it's an unreleased game. There's gotta be a couple of grammatical mistakes in there. You can't fault them for everything. I forgot to change Zero's outfit. Oh well, I hope he's cool looking. Yeah, this guy. This guy right here. I don't like, it doesn't have a good range on it. I gotta get, like, really close to my enemies. And right now, that's... Jesus, Christmas on July 4th is a holiday that doesn't exist. I'm just coming up with swears now. Zero. Well, I just kind of stood there. The reload time is what is really killing me. If I could contra this bad boy and just like turbo laser this shit, like I'd be all right. I really would. Plus one HP, well that's something. This game does not give you a lot of help. Is unforgiving. If I had one note to the developers, like, this is level one, guys. Like, give me a little bit of help. Just make me enjoy the game before you try to rate me with its difficulty. Christ on a cracker, there's enough sprites in this game to choke a camel, who I assume can swallow things with little difficulty on a normal occasion. I am well versed on the digestive habits of desert animals. After all, this is level the desert. Wow, I brought that back around, didn't I? Incredible. My tangents aren't tangents. They're just really convoluted side thoughts. All right. Whoa. No. I feel like I want to switch the L and R buttons because for some reason I press the opposite when I want to do this. No shooting hork back. Homing effect. I can't afford that. Coin magnet. Who gives a fuck about coins? What's coins going to get me? More coins? Alright, there's no knockback effect. Can I use this to my advantage? Alright, middle row is for losers. Jesus, I didn't even see that I had died. It happened so quickly, I restarted the level before I could even think that it was going to be reality. Alright, Wesley Snipes. Back. I assume his last name is Snipes, right? Like, it's not Wesley Cooper. It's not Wesley Smith. Nah. Maybe it's Wesley Eastwood. Wesley Eastwood. Little worm bugs. Bunch of little earth graboids. Blah, gross. Nobody likes worms. Especially when they're in your crotch and they're of the sexually transmitted disease variety. Ugh, gross. All right. Oh, I almost had that. I almost got out of the way in time, but I forked it up. Speaking of forks, y'all see The Good Place on NBC? Gosh, that is an excellent show. Probably my favorite new comedy on television, and the season finale was fantastic. One of the best season finales I have ever seen. Real talk, no lie. I am not being paid by Comcast to say that. Whoa. Who, if you didn't get the joke, they own NBC Universal, which is the channel it is, you know, paying attention here, you gotta know your corporate ladders, who's in charge of who, Time Warner, Verizon, Sony, Fios Pictures, Reebok Advertising Incorporated, that's one big company, I just made that up, okay. Heavy bullets, increased damage and gravity shots, extra ammo, slippery cartridge, faster reload. Let's go with the heavy bullets, let's fuck them up with the heat. If I can, oh, I got plus. All right, so go right into the. What is this? Gravity bullets? I don't like that. That's helpful if I'm up above, but I like to hang out on the bottom level. I know nobody can come up from beneath me. I don't know. What is more strategically sound? The top level or the bottom level? I feel like it's the bottom. I think my headspace and my geographical strategery is at a advantage when I'm on the southernmost tier of the High Noon Revolver game space. And this is, as I mentioned, its most unique aspect is the fact that you have to play three tiers at once. You're playing a triple side scroller. That's what makes this game unique. It's not one side scroller. It's three in one. This is a really, really challenging game, High Noon Revolver. I don't know if I like that. I kind of like my games to be enjoyable, not frustrating. That's just me, though. Maybe you're weird. Maybe you're into, like, you know, that masochistic S&M bullshit. I don't know. Go watch 50 Shades Darker if you're into that crap. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Dorian Gray, whatever his name is. He's hot. He's a cutie. He's a cutie with money, you know what I mean? Like Donald Trump Jr., am I right? I'm not right, he's ugly. Eric Trump, though. No, he's a looker. Oh, this administration, if anything, is going to give me excellent jokes for the next 4 years. Until we impeach him and elect President Pence. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, no, shoot. Oh, God, we're all going to die. I'm going to stay here forever. That little spiky dude's not going to do jack diddly. Oh, come on. That's bullshit. They spawn on top of me? That shouldn't be allowed. Come on, guys. Come on. I have to be mindful of what I say because it occurs to me, like, when I make errant just complaints and or suggestions, like, there's actually a really strong possibility the developers of this game will see this video, take my criticism to heart, and actually fix the game accordingly, or be offended and insulted by some of my disparaging commentary. And I say this because when I'm finished, I'm going to send them a link to this because that's sort of what they requested. Like, play our game, feature it. Also, let us know if you do, because, you know, don't be a dick. We haven't played Chicken Man. Revives after death, but decreases max HP. Let's try the Chicken Man. So basically, I can only get... it's 3, 2, 1. So you get 6. You have 6 health instead of 5. So the reviving thing is okay, but effectively it's just like having one guy of 6. But it's a little less advantageous than that because you can't increase your health. Whereas if I drop down to 1, I can replenish back to 5. Whereas this guy, once you drop, you're kind of stuck. I like Wesley the best. I think he gives me my best chance for success. Blue is my favorite color. Let's finally give Wesley Snipes the color he deserves to succeed in High Noon Revolver. Available on all platforms this Wednesday. Find some health. Oh, shoot. Was that good? Did I just kill everybody or did I kill myself? Because it looks like I killed myself. Okay, I thought I got hit there. That's good. I'm down with that. Oh, yeah, you like that? Horseshoe, no shooting knockback, turtle shell rolling, deflects projectiles, increased damage and gravity sheds. I like the no shoot, the no shockback, whatever you recoil. All right, so I'm halfway done with the level. You look at the bottom of the screen, halfway there, full health, got a couple of upgrades in my arsenal now, so now it's just play smart. Don't get cocky, kid. Oh, Jesus. Oh, I did take him out. Ooh. All right, let's just hang out on the bottom. Oh, Jesus. Oh. I think I'm going to call it quits there, because there is no chance I'll make it to the end of this level without dying, without putting in another 15 hours of gameplay and practice. And even then, if I am certain... 1,000% certain I will not be able to beat the boss on my first try, which means I'll have to do it at least twice. Ain't nobody got time for that. High Noon Revolver, I'm going to give this a 3 out of 5. 3 levels, 3 out of 5. I think that's a fair rating for this one. It's really enjoyable, and it's really challenging. I take that back. It's really challenging, and because of that, it's not as enjoyable as it could be. I think the music was excellent. Sound design was great. The characters, the abilities, all that stuff is fun. But I think if you were able to carry over your upgrades or just have a slightly shallower learning curve. Just like, this is level one. This isn't the end of the game. I can't even get halfway through the first level. And I think that is a chief and insurmountable design mistake when you make your very first level that difficult to get over. It zaps any motivation I have to continue. So on that note, check it out if you want. Link in the description below. The game drops on January 25th. It's called High Noon Revolver, and it's from the folks over at Space Boy Games in partnership with Mike Studios. So thank you to them for giving me the key and allowing me to play it early. And that will do it for this episode of Game Time. Thank you, as always, for watching and listening. My name is John, and I'll see you next time.